These vampires are bullies. This country's president is... he's terrified of Supremo.
Who is the Supremo?
No one dares to mention his name. Because of great fear, the powers he has are so vast and strong. There's a hidden floor below basement 2. That's where the vampire's lair is. Supremo's there too. Only vampires like me have access to that floor. And prepare yourself for the things you're gonna see.
I think we should attack while they're unprepared.
We're not gonna do that. They outsmarted us before, so now it'll be our turn to do that. You're going against powerful creatures. What if you get killed instead?
We are ready to die for everyone's welfare and safety. That is the duty of a moon chaser.
Joey, am I a coward?
Our group's main objective is to fight for mankind's freedom. So we don't have the right to make you a prisoner of a life that you don't want.
Joey, where's Lauren?
You saw for yourself how dangerous that place is.
You know that I'm the only one who can do this.
This war you're facing is a difficult one. This not only involves werewolves and vampires. I'm sure plenty of mortals will be in harm's way.
If we don't do anything, this will continue.
What's your plan, the new chosen one?
Get me a job at the heat bar.
Your move was unexpected. Nobody saw it coming.
He was avoiding an enemy.
He's a good kid. He doesn't have enemies. If there's anything about him which makes me concerned, it's his interest in the supernatural.
He's been looking for vampires?
And he also joined a group, Moon Chasers.
They're already here!
Secure the Senator!
They're already here!
There's a very dark force. It's a really evil energy. There's danger.
Is it Tristan?
Tristan!
And I'm never going to stop until every single one of my plans finally becomes reality for you.
I still can't contact Tristan.
Is it just me? Because I have a bad feeling about this.
Tristan, where are you?
My grandson, he likes going out a lot. Even if we forbid him to, he would still go into the woods so he could look for spiders. He'd climb trees too. He was a restless kid.
And when he knew his father was about to spank him, he would run fast and hide behind me, looking for an ally. Right?
That's true. He even ran away from home one time because he had a fight with his father. When he came home, he had corn with him. A peace offering for his father.
All right, then. I will allow you to have one corn, but promise you'll give it to your father. Mm-hmm. Don't forget your promise. Mm-hmm.
You know what? Tristan may be mischievous, but he is a very kind boy.
Please don't worry. I'm pretty sure he'll call you soon.
I hope he does.
I do too.
You should
go ahead, Mio.
I'll have my men pick up the bodies. But... who's gonna tell their parents?
Every member of the Moonchasers took a sacred oath. They swore that no one will know of the things that they're doing, or whatever it is that may happen to them.
I see. They're like Luna's soldiers. I'm so sorry about this. I'll make sure that those kids who died will get a decent funeral. I will take care of the press and their parents as well.
Oh, thank you, Senator.
Who is that?
We did what you ordered, Supremo. We got one of them alive.
And the Senator?
It was your group that saved Luniming Ramos, right? Who runs your organization?
You should just kill me.
Seen what happens to mortals who enter the VIP floor of the Heat Bar. It's hard to become part of the staff. Once their loyalty has been proven, the candidates are turned into vampires.
Malia, please remember that you'll have a probationary period before they kill or turn you. And before that period is over, your mission should be done.
Senator Rodolfo Magliari was on his way to help conduct relief operations in Mirasol when armed men blocked his convoy. The senator survived, but no less than 20 people from his team have died, including a group of young people who were volunteers in the senator's projects. Here is our interview with the senator.
I can't think of anyone who'd do this, except for those who want to stop the causes I'm fighting for.
We've learned that aside from some members in your security group, some of those who died are young volunteers.
Innocent young adults. Those kids, their courage and dedication to bringing change into our society is unmatched. I have nothing but admiration for their bravery.
Among the young people who died were Joey Angela Martinez, Lauren Catapa, Rocky Salvador, Shelo Trinidad, and Mikey Guido.
I've seen them before. I know those people. I couldn't stop them from killing Joey.
Put him down.
There was nothing I could do when they took Rambo.
Tristan, get some rest.
Prof! Chloe! Chloe! Prof!
Prof!
Please help Chloe! Chloe!
Give me the serum! The serum!
Wait,
faster.
Prof, there's no more serum!
I'm gonna make more serum! Hold her down!
Chloe! Chloe! You can do this! Come on, Chloe!
Maybe now you'll give me information about your group.
I'm not gonna put my friends' lives in danger. I would rather die than put other people in harm's way.
Then I'm just going to play with you.
You worthless creature. Allow the two of us to fight. Your mission was an easy one. And you still failed?
Forgive us, Lero.
I'll have to kill Senator Maliani myself.
Those kids who died were members of a group. And they knew that I'm a vampire. They tried to kill me before. They have members who are clearly expert fighters. If they're just ordinary people, why were they chasing me? They would have gotten scared and left.
Why do the news say they're volunteers for Senator Maliari?
I don't believe that.
Are you telling us that their deaths were...
The senator slated to win the presidential elections next year.
It was made to look like an ambush, but it was vampires all along?
They're vigilantes. Those with a personal vendetta against vampires.
Prof, I need to go home. My family must be worried.
Do you think that seeing you in that condition would erase their worries?
Hey, Tristan!
Go ahead. Carry him. Be careful.
If there's anyone left of their group, we need to find them. If we share the same objective, which is to defeat the evil vampires, it will be better to join forces with them.
I'm gonna look for them.
I'm going to help with your search.
Dory.
Oh.
I really am sorry. I wasn't able to sell all the corn. I couldn't keep myself from worrying about Tristan.
It's okay.
I believe in Star. Her predictions are rarely wrong.
Hmm.
Oh, that hurts. We shouldn't believe psychics and their predictions. What's important is we keep praying.
That's what we should do. Just pray. And another tip. You shouldn't believe in gossip or speculation.
Mother.
Mio.
I'm guessing Tristan hasn't called you yet?
If there's anything about him which makes me concerned, it's his interest in the supernatural, like vampires. And he also joined a group. Moon Chasers.
Vampires. Do they exist? Some people believe that vampires arrived in the Philippines as early as the pre-colonial era from a European country. In order to survive, they learned to coexist with the natives. And as immortals, they learned to adapt to the culture and way of life of the Filipinos.
Are you with the Moon Chasers, Tristan?
Not a single text or call from him?
I haven't stopped calling his cell phone. He's still not picking up.
Oh, I'm sorry, Betty. I went ahead and used your kitchen. I made corn soup.
Thank you so much, Dory.
It's nothing.
It's good you cooked. Mother might just work up an appetite now that you've cooked
for
us.
I don't think I'll have the appetite to eat when my grandchild is missing.
Betty, I just thought maybe we should go to that place called Mirasol.
Oh my, where exactly is Mirasol? From what I know, that place is really huge.
Mio, didn't Tristan tell you anything about where he's going? Do you know who he's with? Maybe we can call someone or go somewhere?
No, he didn't say. When I asked him about work, the only thing he told me was that he needed to do it for his family.
For his family? How could that be true when we're here, worried sick about him?
Oh, wait a minute. Go ahead and have some soup. Come on, here.
Please.
Yes, you should eat.
Tristan, where are you?
I've developed two kinds of serum. I call this one the Lifesaver, because if you inject it into a victim's heart, it'll effectively prevent the spread of the toxin which comes from vampire's nails. The second serum is top secret. This is a very unique combination of werewolf and vampire blood. This is the reason their wounds heal much faster than that of humans. I synthesized it for use on people. Normally for us, a wound would heal in about several weeks. But with this, it's just days. 90% faster.
It can speed up healing of wounds? By 90%?
That is a medical breakthrough. This is the result of my many years of study on vampires. Now, we just wait.
I'll send help to the families of your deceased comrades. I have funds. We have resources. I have everything. And if we don't have what you need, I'll get it for you.
Thank you very much, Senator, for the trust and confidence you've given.
These youth are role models. They have the heart to fight against the evil forces in this world. I wish everyone had your courage and principles. I promise you right now, I'll do everything in order to stop the vampire's evil plans.
Kisses. Kisses. Oh, goodness. So cute.
You look like you're in a bad mood. Are you upset?
I'm not, Father. Just thinking of Tristan.
Why?
He doesn't know his family. He's so worried about him.
Yes, I agree. I pity his grandparents. They couldn't eat because they're worried about their grandson.
Come on, Mio. There must be an important reason behind his actions. We know Tristan real well, don't we? He cares for his family.
There probably was an emergency. Or what if something bad has happened? That's why he hasn't been in touch.
Well then, let's just pray. Nothing is impossible with faith.
And besides, I'm quite sure nothing bad is going to happen to that kid. I'm positive he's fine.
That's right.
You know what I noticed? You've quickly gotten close to each other.
He is a nice person. Even if that guy is mischievous, he's kind to our family. That's it. Well, enough of that. I have to get going now. Father. Bye, Mother. Bye, Greta.
Goodbye. Mio. Please take care. You wouldn't want us all to worry about you, right?
I wouldn't want that.
All right.
Bye.
Bye, Mio.
Oh, that's not a problem at all, Betty. I'm prepared to do anything for you.
Where are we going again?
To that group, the Moon Chasers.
Mother's so worried about Tristan.
He hasn't come home until now, and we haven't heard from him.
Oh, no. Well, I don't know where they are.
But I know someone who might.
We should ask that person.
Who is this? A co-worker of Tristan's?
I promise you, sweetheart. I won't let anyone hurt you. You can count on that. I'm going to keep you out of harm's way.
Tristan, you need to rest. Give your body time to heal. Your wounds are quite deep, you know, so I need to give you another dose of the serum. Lay down. Get some rest. There. Just be patient. You'll feel better.
Are the cameras running?
Yes, ma'am.
Remember, your priority right now is the safety of everyone who's living here.
Yes, ma'am.
Especially Rodolfo.
Understood.
Okay, you may go now. Honey! I'm glad you're safe. How did things go?
I feel sad.
Dad!
Dad. It's been a long day. You should get some rest, too.
Okay.
Good night.
Thank you.
Don't try to escape, Senator. I just came so I could talk to you.
So you're Supremo.
I'll be honest with you, Senator. I came so that I could invite you to join me. Together with the other powerful and influential people in the government. We will lead everyone and dominate the whole nation. You don't want to? Don't you want to stay in the government? You'll be able to keep your post if you join me.
And side with evil? Is that what you're saying?
Isn't it true that all government officials want to keep going and remain in position?
I would rather become an ordinary citizen than obtain a position by dishonorable means.
Well, in that case, I want you to tell me, Senator, what is it that your heart desires the most?
I would like to see every Filipino leading lives free from poverty and evil. I want a life of comfort and abundance for all.
What your heart truly desires is for others to have better lives?
Because that's the only way to go. I really want to be president. So I can defeat you. And stop you from spreading evil to everyone.
And you think you can do that by yourself?
You'll eventually find your match. Even if you're powerful, someone will come to defeat you. If I'm not able to stop you, that doesn't mean you've already won the fight. Because I believe there will be someone who will step forward and hinder you. And this person continues to believe that good always triumphs over evil. So even if I lose, that person will finish you off.
Excuse me. The person who passed away, is she one of the casualties from the ambush in Senator Malyari?
Yes, you got that right. The senator was here.
Okay, thanks.
Senator. You have no idea what I'm capable of doing. I just gave you an opportunity to side with me. You should have said yes. Because whether you like it or not, you're going to be one of us. Do you actually believe you can kill me with that thing?
I can't believe it. It was so sudden. Joey was a really good person.
She was. It's too bad.
She was very talented as well.
It's so sad she wasn't able to say goodbye to her family.
Joey, my dear.
Rodolfo!
Daddy!
Rodolfo!
Daddy!
Daddy!
The wake of all the casualties are held here. I already asked the other families if they or their children knew Joey, but it seems that they don't.
I asked the parents, and when their kids asked for permission, they said that they were sleeping at a friend's house.
I saw one of the bodies. Goodness, it was mangled. They'll find a way to fix it. It could be quite expensive, though.
Be quiet. I know that, too. You shouldn't say anything. Whatever it is that the family's been told, whatever's in the news, stick to that.
They were supposedly ambushed by armed men. But how come the bodies are mangled?
Please allow us to go to the wake, Prof. No one will know that we're there.
I told you that you can't go there. How can you be sure there aren't any vampires hanging around that place?
Prof, can we not give them the proper goodbye that they deserve?
Please don't worry about that. Senator Magliari has already made the necessary arrangements for all of them, so everything's taken care of. So then, I won't stop you if you want to pray or offer masses for them. Go ahead, but I'm never going to allow you to go to the wake.
Ma'am! The news is Senator Magliari is dead!
What? He was just here earlier.
He committed suicide.
What? Really?
That's what I heard. Supremo is responsible for the senator's death?
It's possible. Senator Magliari was a front-runner in the upcoming presidential elections. You all know that Supremo continues to strengthen his forces. He might have attempted to convince the senator to join his side.
So this could mean that the ambush in Senator Magliari was done by vampires. They wanted to get to him so they could turn him into one of them. It just so happened that those young people were there to stop their plans.
It wasn't a simple ambush where the victims were shot to death. A fight occurred there. And from what I've heard, the funeral parlor had to hide the wounds and gashes on the bodies. It was vampires who ambushed them.
I was just wondering, why were those young people there? And how did they know that vampires were going to attack?
This group is experienced. If they are brave enough to face the vampires and put up a fight, then it only means they are an organized team. They might have weapons that could kill vampires. And the most important thing of it all, someone is giving them information about Supremo's next target. I suspect that the info came from a vampire. And that's why we need to meet this team.
I want to help people who have been victimized by the vampires. But then, it's very difficult to continue. When the people who are by your side fighting with you, those who share your objective, become victims themselves. I thought that I was brave enough. But when I lost many of my comrades, I got discouraged and lost faith. But this loss has now given me more reasons to kill every single one of those vampires. And I will never stop until this world is rid of them.
Jake, what is that? Is that a chain made of silver?
Getting rid of Senator Magliari was an extremely easy task. But I had to do it myself since all of you failed. I want you to tell me. Why were those teenagers with the Senator at the exact time when you were going to attack him?
I don't know, Supremo.
How in the world did those mortals know? When you were going to ambush him. Just get out now! Except for you, Vereen.
Ask someone else, dude.
Piolo, just do it. I can't answer their phone calls. I'm stuck here. I'm pretty sure they're looking for me.
Tristan, I stutter whenever I lie. I might just crack if they ask me where you are. Ask someone else.
Piolo, I beg you. I really need to know how they are. It's important. Something bad could have happened to them. Bro, please.
I know someone in our group is hiding their true motives. I suspect that there's a spy amongst us.
A spy, beloved Supremo?
That's right. One of my followers is a traitor. Somebody has dared to oppose me and hinder my plans. It's you. It's you who now has the responsibility to find out who that traitor is.
As you wish, beloved Supremo.
I swear that the minute I find out who has gone behind my back and betrayed me, I will give him a punishment that's worse than death.
Please sit down.
Thank you so much, Neri. By the way, this is Betty. She's the aunt of Tristan.
Nice to meet you.
Sorry for bothering you, Neri. You see, my mother is so worried. We still couldn't contact Tristan.
To be honest with you, it's been a long time since he and I talked, so I don't know where he is either.
Really? We were just taking a chance. If we couldn't find Tristan at work, I figured he could be with the Moonchasers.
I'm sorry, Doc, but Tristan did not join our group.
He didn't? Neri, let me ask you something. Doc here told me some stuff about your group, the Moonchasers. Is it true that you're looking for vampires?
No, we're not. Well, our group was formed out of a shared interest in vampire stories and films that feature them, but we don't go out there looking for real vampires. The truth is, when Tristan first met our group, he got kind of turned off, so he never hung out with us again. So, Doc, the last time I went to your auto shop was the last time Tristan and I talked. I'm very sorry if I couldn't be of any help to you today.
Don't worry, Betty. Nothing bad's gonna happen to Tristan. Who knows? Maybe he's just busy at work. He's going to contact you. Or maybe he's already gone back home.
Here's the last dose of the serum.
Ow!
After a few days, you will fully recover.
Yes.
Do you know where Tristan is?
I haven't seen him, Prof.
When I woke up, he wasn't in his bed.
Well, maybe he's just with Piolo.
Piolo's here.
Hey, guys. What's going on?
Do you know where Tristan went?
Huh? Wait. Tristan is missing?
I'm really sorry, Grandma. Please don't worry about me. I just need a little more time. You'll only worry more if you see me right now. Please forgive me. I'll come home as soon as I get well. I really want to be with you again.
Tristan! Where are you going? Your family is worried about you. They even asked me if I knew where you were.
Just let me be for now.
That's what we're doing, isn't it? We're all letting you be. You're free to do what you want. But you could have gotten in touch with them. Instead, you come and check on them quickly and then leave again. Think about your grandparents. They're old and fragile. Don't let them worry about you.
But you don't understand me. I have my reasons. At this point, I can't let my family see me.